office the minute it happens. We have information about why this raid began. We'll bring that to you in just one moment. But first, we have some dramatic footage of this raid. Two people killed as it was taking place. Let's watch. Again, this video from the town of Verviers in Belgium. Two dead, one wounded in an anti-terror raid there, believed to be directed against an ISIS-inspired, perhaps even ISIS-orchestrated group that had been planning to attack European targets. I want to bring in our terror analyst, Paul Cruikshank. Paul has been developing this information. Paul, what can you tell me about this ISIS-directed group that was the target in Belgium over the last few hours?
Hey, John. Yeah, I've been speaking to a senior Belgian counterterrorism official that these guys have been under surveillance for a while, and their concern has been that after they came back from Syria, that they were planning to launch some sort of terrorist attack. The Belgian authorities weren't sure exactly what, when, and how, but the Belgians received indications that this group, when they were in Syria, had connected with ISIS and had been directed to some extent by ISIS to come back and return to Europe to launch attacks. That would be a kind of game changer. We've not seen that yet from ISIS. They have not prioritized attacks in the West yet. So it's a very, very concerning indeed if they're now putting their very considerable resources into launching attacks back in Europe in retaliation for these airstrikes from the United States and other countries. Belgium is involved in those airstrikes in Iraq. And so the Belgians were worried that this group were plotting perhaps something against Belgium to retaliate for Belgium's involvement in the anti-ISIS coalition. They were putting a lot of pieces of intelligence together, but they were growing more and more worried in recent weeks. And with, of course, this attack in France just 1 week ago, they were concerned that they would be inspired to go and launch their attack. And so the Belgians felt that they had to go in, they had to round these people up. It appears that some of these suspects were armed. I mean, Belgian police wouldn't normally go in all guns blazing, so I think that's highly suggestive of the fact some of these people were heavily armed. And we now understand that several of the suspected terrorists were killed in this operation, John.
We know so far two dead, one wounded in this anti-terror raid, a group that Paul Cruikshank tells us was an ISIS-directed group in Belgium. ISIS wanted them to start attacks against European targets in retaliation for the coalition bombing of ISIS in Syria and Iraq. Of course, here in Paris, the question everyone wants to know is, are there any connections at all to the attacks here last week? I'm standing here with Fred Pleiken, who's been covering the attacks here with me over the last week. And Fred, we did learn of an arrest in Belgium just over the last few hours. A man who had bought a car from the girlfriend of Amadou Koulibaly, the man who attacked the kosher market, and is now being held on weapons charges for perhaps supplying some kind of weapons here.
Yeah, a man who was a known arms dealer. He was in Charleroi, which is in a different part of Belgium, but nothing in Belgium is very far apart because it's not really a very big country. It is very much unclear whether these two events are linked, whether it's linked to this anti-terror operation that's happened right now. This man, of course, we know, turned himself into police on Tuesday. So that perhaps it might not be related at this point. It simply is too early to tell. But there's two things that I think are absolutely key in all of this. One of them is that Belgium, and many people don't know this, Belgium in Europe is the country per capita with the highest amount of people that go to fight for organizations like ISIS in Iraq and Syria. And of course, the Belgians for a very long time have been very worried about some of these people coming back and perpetrating attacks. The other thing that we have to know about the sort of European jihadist scene is that borders don't really matter. Mm-hmm. The people who perpetrate something like this in Belgium might very well be connected to people here in France. The borders are transcendent. Many of them are people who come from migrant families from Northern Africa. So there is a common bond there between those people. And a lot of them, of course, don't feel like they belong in this society in Belgium or in France. So it really is not like you're seeing this transcend countries, mm-hmm. even though it is. It really is a common European problem that we're talking about.
One thing to keep in mind, Amadou Coulibaly, the man who attacked the kosher market here, says he was inspired by ISIS. Our Paul Cruikshank tells us right now, the raid in Belgium, in the town of Verviers, that left two people dead and one wounded, that was directed at an ISIS-directed group, he says. A security source here in France told me moments ago also that one thing about Belgium is there's a lot of arms trade, a great deal of weapons that come through that country to other points in Europe, so keep that in mind as well. I want to bring in reporter Chris Burns, formerly of CNN right now, who is in Belgium. Chris, what can you tell us? What are you hearing about this raid in Verviers?
Well, John, what we're hearing and what I'm seeing here in the Belgian media is that the Belgian television is now reporting three dead in that operation in Verviers. This was part of a nationwide operation in a number of cities. They're reporting operations in Brussels, in two towns just outside of Brussels. This, of course, following what happened in Paris, and the link of arms, the arms that were found, that the arms traders that were involved in selling the arms to the attackers in France. And so that's why the police are really cracking down right now and trying to round them up to try to prevent any further. There have been operations going on called Vigipirate. It's the scaled-up security operation, patrolling, checking, searching. That had been going on for the last few weeks. But at this point now, of course, what had happened in France has really gotten the anti-terrorist operations stepped up, scaled up here, and perhaps just in time. John.
Chris, to be clear, the Belgian media that you're listening to right now, they are saying there's a weapons connection between the group that was targeted today and perhaps the attacks here in Paris last week?
No, that is not yet been established. We're going to have to see what is said at the press conference at this hour, to be held this hour in Brussels by the federal police. So we'll see what they say. But the police have stepped operations because of this link that was found not between what happened actually in Verviers yet, but there had been weapons that had been traced to the attackers in France, to a market, a well-known market here in Brussels, near the southern train station, where there are fairly illicit operations going on there sometimes, the sale of illicit drugs and weapons there. And then also there had been a link to an arms dealer who lived in Charlevoix, which is south of Brussels. There's an airport over there. So that had been the two links that were made, and perhaps, we have to find out from police, but perhaps there had been a link to what happened in Villevorde, in Belvier, but we need to confirm that.
Okay, excellent. Thank you very much for laying that out for us. Again, you're looking at video right now of this raid that happened in the town of Verviers in Belgium. A raid that apparently left two, although there is Belgian media reporting three people dead. The raid was targeting an ISIS-directed group. That is, according to CNN analyst Paul Cruikshank, an ISIS-directed group that had been told to start attacking European targets in retaliation for the coalition bombing inside Iraq and Syria. I want to bring in former Assistant FBI Director Tom Fuentes. And Tom, this is exactly what people have feared in the West now for months. The idea that Westerners, whether it be in these European countries, in Canada, perhaps even in the United States, could go to Iraq and Syria, then go home and perhaps engage in terror operations in their countries. Paul Cruikshank suggests that is what was at least being attempted to happen here in Belgium before this raid today.
That's exactly right, John, and we've been saying for months that people from over 50 countries have traveled to Syria and Iraq to learn how to fight war, to learn how to deal with explosives and heavy weapons and RPGs. And we said they're going to go home at some point, and many have already now. And when they get home, it's just going to be a matter of time before we start seeing these attacks. And we've had hundreds and hundreds go from European countries, but they're from every country, every continent, including the U.S., Canada, Australia. So it's not just limited to Europe, but I think what we're seeing is what's been predicted for a long time. This has been like watching a hurricane coming and growing and growing and gradually making landfall, and now we have the results now.
Paul Cruikshank, if you're still with us, I do want to ask you a question, because I understand you've got some more reporting suggesting that all of Europe right now has been told to be on the lookout. This is a new sense of alertness here for these ISIS-inspired attacks.
Yeah, I mean, they're very worried about both the ISIS-inspired attacks, which are the kind of lone wolf attacks by people inspired by ISIS's calls to launch attacks in retaliation, but perhaps even more worried about these returning fighters coming back from Syria and Iraq. And my understanding is that there are now more than 500 European nationals back on European soil who fought with jihadi groups in Syria and Iraq. I mean, that's an unprecedented number, impossible to monitor them all the time. And so there's great concern that some may get through the cracks and be able to launch attacks. Clearly, the Belgians have decided to go in before that could happen in their country, go in and apprehend this group who they suspect were connected with ISIS in Syria, and suspect that ISIS encouraged and directed to come back and launch attacks. After the attack played out in Paris just a week ago, they couldn't take any chances anymore. But this is a real problem for the Belgians. About 150 the Belgian nationals right now in Syria fighting with ISIS and other jihadi groups. Around 70 have returned. The Belgian authorities are telling me that every month another 15 extremists make their way towards Syria to join these groups. And that gives you a sense of the scale of this problem, the scale of this challenge. There's a lot of radicalization right now. And the whole system, the radical system, has been energized by these attacks against the Charlie Hebdo magazine a week ago, concerned that these kind of people would be inspired to accelerate plans, and that's why they went in.
All right, Paul Cruikshank, thank you very much. Stand by, please. We are awaiting a live news conference from inside Belgium. Key questions: what exactly spurred this raid? How close could this ISIS-inspired group in Belgium have been to staging some kind of attack? Was there any connection to the attacks here in Paris? A live news conference coming up. We'll be right back.
It's a warning. Wake-up call. But it's not happening out there. It's happening in here. Inside of you. Even if you're treating your Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, an occasional flare may be a sign of damaging inflammation. Learn more about the role damaging inflammation may be playing in your symptoms with the expert advice tool at crohnsandcolitis.com, and then speak with your gastroenterologist.
Returning home from the battlefield, only to face a new war as they struggle with devastated injuries. At Wounded Warrior Project, we understand. We're there to help.
I ended up with third-degree burns over 40 to 50% of my body.
The burns were horrifying, and the pain that he endured is just unimaginable.
See the doggies over there? You can honor and empower those who have sacrificed so much for us.
Remember what hand this is?
With a gift of just $19 a month, you can join Wounded Warrior Project. You'll help provide critically needed programs and services that rebuild lives.
Everyone's road to recovery is different, and Wounded Warrior Project has played such a huge role. I'm so grateful to Wounded Warrior Project for everything they've done.
He still struggles. He's in pain every day, and it's devastating. He's the best.
Maybe you should draw a Valentine's Day card for your mom.
Oh, yeah.
Do some different colors.
He loves us so much. And one day he told Kingsley that that we're a team, the three of us.
Mommy and Daddy and me.
Would you like it?
For many of our wounded heroes, the greatest casualty is being forgotten. That's why your gift of just $19 a month is so important. Call now. Or go online with your gift, and we'll send you this Wounded Warrior Project blanket.
The impact that it can make on people's lives is huge.
They can make a difference. There are real warriors who are facing real troubles. They just need people to know that they care.
Wounded Warrior Project is providing support and care wherever it is needed. Please call or go online right now.
Closed captioning brought to you by InventHelp. Call 1-888-909-4332.
People ask me all the time, George, what do I do with my idea for a new product? I tell them, call my friends at InventHelp.
Call for free information.
All right, welcome back. John Berman live in Paris. More than a week after the terror attacks here, we just learned over the last several hours there has been an anti-terror raid in Belgium, the town of Verviers. In that raid, at least two people were killed, at least, could be more. One person wounded. We are told the group that was targeted was an ISIS-directed group inside Belgium, tasked with carrying out attacks against Western targets in retaliation for the coalition airstrikes against ISIS in Iraq and Syria. Again, at least two people dead in these raids, could be more. We're waiting a live news conference, which could begin any minute, from the federal prosecutor in Brussels, who will explain to us exactly what made them stage this raid, exactly when they did, exactly what kind of intelligence they had. I'm joined by Chris Burns, former CNN reporter who is in Belgium. He can tell us, Chris, what are you hearing? What new information do you have?
Well, John, what we're seeing on Belgian media is that the police were quite attentive to these individuals and others that had been coming back from Syria. And according to Belgian media, they're saying that the police had been watching and wiretapping many of them in recent weeks. And that is what prompted them to make the move now, that there were indications that at least some of them were planning some kind of an action in Brussels itself, and that it was time to move in on them. So what we're seeing is actions within Brussels and as in towns just outside called Molenbeek and in Vilvoorde, and of course we saw what happened in Velvier. So they are acting now quickly, decisively. It is a part of this what's called Vigipirate. It's a stepped up security operation that's been going on for weeks, but of course after what happened in Paris a week ago, this is what really stepped up their actions now. It is not clear what sort of attacks that these individuals were planning, but the police, according to Belgian media, they said that they had been planning something, and that's why they had to stop them now.
Wiretaps on individuals that had been returning from the ISIS fight in the Middle East, presumably in Iraq and Syria, causing Belgian officials to stage this raid in the town of Verviers that left at least two people dead. Chris, stand by for a moment. I'm here in Paris with Fred Pleiken. And Fred, you've got some information now about this town where they are, Verviers.
Verviers is apparently a town that does have some people who have made their way to fight for ISIS in Syria. In fact, we have confirmation that over the past year, at least three individuals from Verviers made their way to fight for ISIS, either in Iraq or Syria. It's not clear exactly where, but apparently one of them on his social media account even bragged about the fact that he shot somebody somewhere in the vicinity of Aleppo. So certainly this is not something that is anything new to that town. It seems there is some sort of Islamist scene there in that town. And we also know that over the past year, in the fall of last year, there was a trial that began in Belgium against a group that was accused of funneling fighters to Syria and Iraq to fight for groups like ISIS. And one of the things that was interesting about that trial is that there were over 40 people who were supposed to stand trial, but only 8 of them actually showed up to the trial because the rest of them apparently were still fighting somewhere in Syria, or at least were in Syria. So this is something, these sort of investigations have been going on in Belgium for a while, but it was interesting also what Chris just said and what Paul was saying as well. It seems as though possibly because of the events that we've seen here in Paris, that maybe the Belgian anti-terror officials believe that now is the time for them to conduct these anti-terror operations, or maybe otherwise they might have just kept observing these
crimes. And we will hear from Belgian officials any minute. We're awaiting a news conference in Brussels from the federal prosecutor there to explain exactly why they launched this raid on this ISIS-directed group. And of course, a key question everyone in France, everyone in Paris, where we are, has right now is there any connection to the attacks in Paris? We haven't heard that there is yet, but it is a question that many, many people have. Paul Cruikshank, I want to bring you in here because the idea of ISIS fighters, Western ISIS fighters, going to Iraq, going to Syria, and returning home to their nations, that has been a fear for months and months and months, but it has just been a fear. You say if it is now in practice, there is a major development.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a fear for quite some time, and it's believed there are up to 3,000 European nationals who've made that trip to Syria or Iraq and are now have been fighting there or returned back. So very, very big numbers, more than 500 back in the European Union right now. Those are very big numbers as well. And what Belgian counterterrorism officials are telling me is they suspect this group, they launched the raid against, were in Syria, were connected to ISIS, and they suspect that the ISIS leadership encouraged or directed them to come back to launch an attack in retaliation for the airstrikes in Syria and Iraq, which have been launched by the anti-ISIS coalition. Belgium itself has been involved in those airstrikes in Iraq. So there may be some motivation from ISIS to launch attacks in Belgium. We know that the spokesman of ISIS back in September said that the group was going to launch attacks in the West in retaliation for the Western offensive against it from the air in Syria and Iraq. And it appears that they may well have been true to their word.
In the framework.
Paul Cruikshank, stand by for a moment here. I believe this press conference is beginning in Brussels right now. I believe there is an English translation. Let's listen in.
Has had 10 searches carried out in Verviers, Bruxelles, Avervaux districts. This was within the framework of an investigation looking into an operational cell made up of people, some of whom were coming back from Syria. The investigation made it possible to determine that the group was about to carry out major terrorist attacks in Belgium imminently. At Verviers, the suspects immediately and for long minutes fired using war weapons and hand weapons before being neutralized. Two of the suspects died, and a third was detained on the site. No witness, no police officer was injured. The investigation is currently continuing, and as you will understand, it's not possible to give any more information in order not to undermine the investigation. Another press conference will be given tomorrow morning at 11 in the morning. Given the significance of this, the police means and special operations were brought in to add their weight to the work of the municipal police of Brussels. We have to say what extraordinary work the federal police force has done, the security forces of the state, and also the special forces of the federal police. Given the situation, the body coordinating an analysis of the threat decided to raise the alert threshold in Belgium to 3 out of 4 levels with respect to police forces throughout Belgium. And it will remain at the level 2 with particular vigilance in certain places.
Pour cette conférence de presse des membres du parquet fédéral qui confirme donc le
A lot of information right there from a Belgian official. I believe that was the federal prosecutor. Let me just read you the information that I wrote down. There was an anti-terror raid in the town of Verviers. It was against a cell of people that had returned from Syria, presumably fighting for ISIS or militant groups there. This group, this cell inside Verviers, was planning a major imminent attack in Belgium. That is why Belgian officials decided to launch the raid. The terror